Welcome today. It's great to have you here. Thank you for your time. I hope you've been able to check out Spark, the event, a little bit and explore the different virtual environment and the different spaces. Today, we're going to be talking about TS 3.0 and cloud. So the name of the seminar is Enabling Modern Work with TS 3.0 and Cloud. A few remarks just before we get started. My name is Carl Standerschild. I'm the Corporate Segment Marketing Manager here at Sony. And I'm joined together today by Thomas. Do you want to introduce yourself, Thomas?
Thank you very much, Carl. Indeed, my name is Thomas Issa, and I'm in charge of the corporate solution within Sony Europe. And more importantly, about all the development, the planning, and the strategy that we do around TIOS, which will be one, of course, of the core item of today.
Thank you, Thomas. Today's seminar is going to be about 20 minutes long. And we will have a Q&A at the end. So if you've got any questions, you can type them into the question bar on the side. You type any questions throughout the presentation, and then I'll answer them at the end with Thomas. So in terms of the agenda today, I'm going to talk a little bit about the corporate market. Then we're going to introduce TIOS 3.0 and our vision for TIOS in general. We're going to look at what's new with TIOS 3.0, the new features and so on. And then we'll explore a little bit the new business model. Thomas will take you through that. We'll look at what's coming next, and then we'll have the Q&A session at the end. So to start off, let's talk a little bit about the corporate market. So as we all know, this past year has been pretty wild. COVID came and hit pretty much a year ago, and it forced all of the office workers to go and work from kitchens and living rooms, and basically just be stuck at home, working at home that whole time. Surprisingly, a lot of people were still very productive and they could work quite well from home. But that wasn't the case for all. You know, there's a lot of people who live with their little kids and they're sharing an apartment with people. They have a very small space at home. It's not really conducive to good kind of productive working. People, you know, many people living on their own, which they had then no connection with colleagues and so on, or just other people in general. So there were also quite a lot of mental impacts and mental health impacts. So people were working quite well at home and remote sort of worked, but it didn't work for everyone. So really COVID kind of normalized the fact that we can work from home. It does work, but the physical office will always be necessary. And there's a few reasons why. Well, mainly, as I mentioned, social stimulation and community. Aristotle said, we're social creatures. So we want to be with other people and we get energy from being with other people and having that connection with others. And you don't get that at home. You know, if I'm doing a Zoom call or a Teams call with someone and I think that they're looking at me and presenting, when I'm presenting, I don't know if they're on their emails, if they're really listening. So it's hard to have that connection. So the second point, collaboration and innovation kind of is connected to that as well. When you have these meetings, you can't really build that kind of connection and trust with the person on the other side of a virtual meeting. But when you're in the actual kind of room with them, you know, you can kind of look at them, you see their the way they react to things, their body language, and that's how you really kind of start to build a relationship with your clients or your colleagues. So really, in-person meetings are much more meaningful, actually. And in terms of brainstorming and any sort of innovation, they're much more effective than virtual meetings. One of the points is really purpose and identity as a person and purpose in your job, in your career. It's all kind of linked to how well immersed you are with your company and your organization. So if you're a new starter, for example, you hire someone new and you have to hire them remotely, yes, you can send them a t-shirt with your logo on and so on. But if they're in the office and they're surrounded by the corporate culture with their colleagues and the space where all the business is being done, you're going to feel much more connected to the organization and a bigger kind of sense of belonging and purpose. And a lot of people then actually kind of tie their personal identity to their work identity and to their job as well. So it's really, really important to have that kind of connection. So these are some of the reasons why actually the physical office will be really necessary moving forward. So though we're in this kind of period where some people are back in the office, others are still stuck at home. There's been big changes in the corporate commercial real estate market. A lot of uncertainty, a lot of questions. It's quite clear that there will be a place for the office moving forward once we all get back to a new way of working. That brings me on to what is the new way of working? What is the new sort of future of work, really? Well, one thing that COVID has kind of proven was that remote working does work to an extent, and it also proved that people want more flexible ways of working. So in the future, companies really are going to have to let employees work how they want to work, because that will be how they will be productive. You know, they can't really say you have to work like this if you're more productive working like that. It's about giving employees the choice. And if you give them the choice on that flexibility, then they're going to be more satisfied. And then you're going to have less people leaving your company. And so you'll have a more retention of talent within the organization. So flexibility really is key, and it's kind of been proven throughout the pandemic now. A lot of companies are already offering flexible working. You know, you see a few logos down there. And I think others are going to really follow, because they're going to see that if they don't offer it and other companies do, then employees might go to an organization where they have more flexibility. It's going to be different by country, different by industry, different by company. It's not going to happen overnight. For some, it is. For some, it's going to take a little bit slower, and some are going to kind of transition slowly to more flexible working practices. But it's quite likely that that is the future of work. So what that means is then you're going to have this kind of blended between virtual work and in physical spaces. And technology is going to be the kind of key to linking that up, to enabling people to be able to come into the office, but book a room remotely or book a desk kind of remotely before they come in. And when they come into the office, they're going to want to have the technology that really helps them work effectively. So the reason is, like, why would you come into the office? You know, you can work at home. So you would be coming in for certain things. You'd be coming in for customer meetings or special interaction with clients, or maybe a really special brainstorming session that's quite important with your colleagues. It's better in person than at home. Things like this. So it's actually, when people come in, it's actually going to be very meaningful. It's going to be for meaningful connections and meaningful business practices. So when they come in, things need to work really well. So companies really need to invest in the technology if they want to achieve longer term cost efficiency. You know, if you invest now and in the right areas, then it's going to have a great impact in the end on your business performance. And meetings are one of those critical kind of areas. I think this kind of then transitions into where we're going with this presentation next.
Indeed, and this is exactly what we aim and what we would like to support with our TIOS corporate solution, not only moving forward, but, you know, like, to make sure that all our customers, all our clients are able to really manage successfully the post-pandemic situation with this new workplace ecosystem. I don't know, Carl, if you can move the slide. Yep. And this is exactly why we are introducing today to you, for the very first time, our new version, so TIOS 3.0, which is going to be like a major step up compared to what we were about to offer previously. Our intention and really our vision behind this solution is really to make everything that we had to offer before much simpler, from a user experience, from an administrator experience, from the deployment to the use and to the perception of any single add-on that we are able to offer to you and to our customers, to make it stronger and better on every single, again, core functionalities that we offer in the platform, from the room booking to the signage, the meeting displays, to the mirroring, the wireless collaboration, and so on. And of course, to make it much more flexible, to support the flexibility required in the corporate workplace, with the flex office, of course, with the life management between the home place and the office place, and so on. And this is really what we aim to provide to all our customers, starting, of course, middle of May with this new release. When we look into it, this will be like, again, a major milestone for us in the development of TIOS that we are offering since 2017, so already 4 years ago. Since the introduction, really what we aim to do is really to provide to you, to all of you, on a regular basis, new functionalities, new add-ons to really, you know, like, make sure that we go along our customers in the challenge that they face on a daily basis inside their workplace, with their employees, with their meetings, and to make sure that we can really bring the value they need to make all their workplace much more efficient on a daily basis. We started with pretty much nothing in 2017, our version 1.0, with just a few functionalities that we have built over time. The version 2, which was, again, a major step up, not only in terms of stability, but in terms of offering that we were to offer to our customers, with a lot of new add-ons, like the reception, the connect, mobile, survey, and so on. And now, really, the goal is to go one step further, in not only in terms of maturity, but in terms of scope, coverage, simplicity, and strong items that we are able to offer and that we are going to present you in a minute.
So, what's new with TIOS version 3.0? So we're going to highlight some of the kind of key updates and features with TIOS version 3.0. So the first one then really is about a new interface and new designs and new templates that we've incorporated. So with the new interface that you can see here on the left on the laptop, you know, we really wanted to simplify the process for admins and users. So we integrated new user interface to make, is it playing? It's a little bit laggy there, but we integrated then a new user interface then to make the process much more seamless and easy to use. For example, we've even added descriptions for different pages. We've added little help bubbles throughout the whole platform. The idea is then it's gonna be easier to navigate, easier to use. You're gonna get more kind of smarter information about what you do with which the different parts of the platform. And so that was one really kind of major change that we've had. And also on top of that, we with this new version, we have 20 new templates across room booking, signage, and the meeting room display as well. You can see some of these templates here on the side. So if you look at the room booking, our 10-inch tablets there, we've got the two different types of tablets that we have, one with the LED lights all the way around, one with LED lights just on the side. And so I'm sure you'd agree that these are really kind of amazing, beautiful templates. We really love them. We've been using them here at the office. We've also got our the 3.5 inch tablet that we've got templates for that as well. You'll see some of the signage there. What's really cool is that we have these kind of dedicated signage templates now for sport, for weather, and other things like that. So you can even get up and started with your signage even faster than before, where it was already easy to create a template. Now we even have all these templates in there already for you.
And this was actually really important to us because we know that in Teos there is a lot of functionalities, a lot of features that you can access, you know, like between from a reception to wayfinding to room booking to signage. And it's not always very easy and simple to navigate between those functionalities to be able to use the platform very simply. Really, our intention there is to make sure that from a UI perspective, from an interface on the administrator side, but also on the perception of the user side, everything becomes much easier. No need to go to a manual, no need to ask yourself a question, how do I need this? All the information will be visible on the platform at any time. And from a template perspective, for example, for the room booking, there will be like all the information required to make sure that any employees from 20 years old up to 60 years old is able to really use a room booking application, a reception application in the much simpler way without again wondering how to do to book or asking himself questions that make him lose any efficiency in the workplace. The second item that we would like to cover today, which brings us to the next slide, and which is really also important for us in terms of, you know, like Teos and support, of course, for any of our partners' projects, and of course, deployments for end users and clients, is really the cloud. Since the start, we were able to offer Teos on the cloud, but on a very specific and secure type of, secure is not the right word because it's still secured, of course, but very complex way. Now with this version 3.0, we have reviewed completely the architecture behind Teos to make sure that it becomes very, very, very simple to deploy on any single location without requiring any server, any specific hardware, that the setup and the access is plug and play and can be done from anywhere to make sure that you can access all the Teos functionalities from the IP control of device, the turn off, turn on, the scheduling, up to the signage, the room booking, the reception, and everything that we can offer in Teos from the cloud, from anywhere in the world at any time, and to make sure using Amazon Web Services for our cloud hosting, that we can provide to you the most robust and the most secured way to make sure that any single data that we use in Teos and that is used in order to control your devices and your application is of course completely secured with the best service performance all over Europe and all over the world. In addition to this, what was really important for us with this version 3.0 is to get really from security to maturity, from stability to maturity. So really to make sure that we are strengthening all our basics which are in the platform, to make sure that again, when anyone uses any, and especially more importantly, on our core functionalities, which are the room booking, the wireless presentation with Teos Connect, signage, and meeting display, that there is again no single issue, no single question asked, no single problem. But really that the perception from the deployment to the use is easy, is proper, and is exactly the way it should be. And we are spending quite a lot of time at the moment to make sure that it is the case. We have done also a lot of improvements now and then in the platform from signage, you know, with more flexibility, new compatibility as well, like Power BI and so on, new functionalities for employees also to make sure that we can offer more services to them and that our customers, of course, are able to offer more services to them. Just to highlight two examples, the incident and catering management are now fully integrated in our room booking and mobile application, meaning that if you're in a meeting room and if you have an issue, you can call for support directly from there. Or if you want to order, I don't know, like 2 coffee and 3 sandwich, you can do it very simply and very easily from any meeting room or for any mobile. All of that will be fully integrated on the background, of course, of TOS. And new functionalities required by our customers, some of them like the dual room booking to decrease their cost using one tablet to manage two meeting rooms with the tablet, of course, in between those rooms with the different information and everything to use, of course, only one license and one tablet for two rooms. In addition, and this is really one of the last items that we really want to highlight today, is of course everything which relates to the flex office. With the post-pandemic situation, with the return to the office, what really raised, like Carl said before, is really the need and the requirement for flexibility, for hybrid working between the home place and the workplace. And this is again really what we would like to support with TOS and with this version 3.0 from TOS. So we are just highlighting there some of the functionalities that will be present, but of course, there is much more inside the platform. But it goes from the QR code compatibility, meaning that you can put a simple QR code on every single desk of your office to just scan the code and to do like easy, simple check-in or check-out of a desk. Of course, you'll be able to book them, to see the availability from your mobile, from Outlook, from any application that you are used to have for TOS. We are doing like zoning, of course, for the desk booking to see very simply the availability of a zone and to book your space. You can choose also the limitation that you want. If you want to reduce the space to 50% or 20% to ensure social distancing, there is no problem for this. All the details and the occupancy will be visible in TOS. We are adding also a few more added value, like the parking spot management, to make sure that if you come one day to the office, you can also book a parking spot if you want to, of course, to make sure that you can really go in the office in the best possible way. And all of this is part of the version 3.0 that we're going to release. So if I have to summarize on that aspect, really our core focus was to make the experience much better with new interface, new templates, to really strengthen our basics from the room booking to the signage, to the meeting display, to TOS Connect, to really bring the flexibility inside this version 3.0 and to offer it anywhere at any time in the most simpler way with the TOS Cloud. On top of this, we really wanted, again, to continue to simplify the platform. So we have done it from our perspective, of course, in the interface. We also wanted to do it from a business model and an ordering perspective. Over the past 4 to 6 years, we brought quite a lot of items, quite a lot of functionalities, quite a lot of license in the platform, and it was becoming very complex. There was a lot of different scenarios, a lot of different add-ons, a lot of different license to order. And it was not easy to really understand the way it works and the way we have to order and to buy, of course, when it comes to TOS. If we go to the next slide. So what we wanted to do is really to make a very simple picture, a very simpler way of understanding our offer and being able to offer, to order. So it goes from 2 types of platform, one for SMB, so small projects, to make sure that we remain very, very competitive for this with a little bit less flexibility, as you can see here, without analytics or Active Directory compatibility or simple signage, but a very aggressive price with a full cloud access. And then, of course, our offer for enterprise, so larger companies with much more requirement, many more offices, and a lot of needed for single sign-on, dedicated line support, no limitation in terms of license, or user, or anything like this. So this is the first step, the main software, and then simply just 3 licenses. One for employee, so this will be required for the employee application, mainly, which is basically €1 per month per employee, and then of course, quantitative discount. Entry license, which is really just for the control of device, for €50 per year per device, and then advanced license, which is quite competitive for everything, so from the device control to the scheduling to the content management, to use it for signage, for room booking, for reception, to mirroring, and so on, for only €120 per year per device. So only 2 offers, SMB and enterprise, cloud or not cloud, and then 3 licenses, depending on what you want to do, employee, control, or anything at all. So this is really important for us because this is a major step also in order to simplify the experience, again, when using TOS. There will be, of course, no impact for our existing customer. This is really not the point. And this is really to, again, make sure that everything becomes much more understandable and easy to proceed when it comes about SEOs. We have one more slide for today, which we really want to use in order to present you our next steps, because we are now already at 20 minutes or so of the presentation. So in here, what we want is really to highlight very simply what we're working on at the moment, just for you to have like a clear picture and a clear overview of what we're preparing in the coming, let's say, two quarters for you. One is, of course, after this version 3.0 release, again, which will happen around middle to end of May, we'll work towards the version 3.1, which will be our next step. For this version, we will continue to focus on strengthening our platform. So we will address new add-ons, like the wayfinding and the reception and the control part, in order to continue to improve the platform. We are preparing also a few surprises, first prize, like we have also like a marketplace for templates and so on, which will come. The next one, Carla,
yeah, we've got the we're working on a 3D office sort of visualization. The idea here is really to kind of create an environment that, you know, with all the virtual working that we're doing today, you know, we don't know how long it's going to last, but it's clear that there is a need more for sort of virtual engagements with partners, with customers, with you know, other stakeholders involved. So we've created we're in the process of creating a sort of 3D office environment where you can go in and you can kind of then see sort of in situ different TEOS and Sony products, of course, in this kind of one space. So it's as handy as a sales tool. You can get more information on products and much more. So we will be kind of sharing that in the coming months as well.
Yeah, this one will be very nice. On top of things, we're also working on the user flows and the technical specs to provide like a full database for frame agreements, for tenders, so to simplify, of course, our channel partners and consultants' job, because SEOs, again, is very wide when it comes about the functionalities and the possibilities which are embedded in the platform. So we really want to support that in a very simple way. We're also working on new services.
Yep, change management service. The idea here really is that, you know, today we've got partners and end users on the call. So for the end users, you know, when you do invest in TEOS and then you kind of set that up in your organization, sometimes, you know, you've done all the hard work, you've invested, and then, you know, maybe technology isn't being used or people don't know how to use it. And so we thought maybe we can help, you know, if a company has already a process for change management, great. If they don't, we can help that. Even if they do, maybe they can take something away from this. So we're creating a little service package that will help in terms of adoption of technology, communication across the organization and so on. That will be coming soon.
Indeed, all of that is just for information coming in the next 2 to 4 months, basically. Also, and as you know, we are not developing SEOs at all for ourselves, I mean, as us as customers, but really for our clients. So it's really important that we make sure that what we do makes sense. So of course, we work a lot with specific customers for, you know, like development which are done on the platform for our customers and coming from our customer demands, with some examples from, I don't know, like Capgemini, for example, from Otto, from and so on, from Mongo. However, what's really important for us is to make sure that anything that we do makes sense for our customers and that we continue to improve ourselves. Of course, we started only, if I can say that, 4 years ago. So the road that was behind us has been already, you know, quite big since we started with the version 1.0. We know again that we are not, you know, like perfect. There is a lot of things that we need to improve. And what we really want is to make sure that we can create an official process to not only gather the information and the satisfaction from our customers, and by customer, I really mean our channel partner and our end user, and also to really be able to use this information to report to those customers and to show really the progress in what we do for the coming years on a really, not a daily basis, of course, but at least on a regular basis. The final item which will come and which will be more related to our partners is to make sure that we can create and provide to them an exclusive site, where they will be able to manage all their projects, where they will be able to gather all the information they require on SEOs, from the documentation to the technical assets to the firmware, the release, and so on. And this will come also, hopefully very soon, by the end of June, basically. So all of that are really items that we're working on. Again, what's really important is that we really aim with everything that we do and that we present today to continue to improve what we do, to improve what we offer to our customers. Version 2.0 is really about the simplicity, the maturity, of the platform, with of course the flexibility and the cloud which comes on top of it. All the things that we just presented now is really to continue to improve your experience working with us or collaborating with us, which is really important for us. And what we aim is really to continue to work into that direction, sorry, in the coming months, coming years, to make sure that, of course, TIOS leads, I want to say the post-pandemic, but really the workplace transformation into better and simpler place where employees can really work in, which is really the goal that we have for ourselves and for TIOS within Sony.
Thank you, Thomas. That's the end of the presentation. Now we're going to have some time for the Q&A. I'm just going to quickly jump into the question panel just to kind of review that. So if you've got any questions at all, please ensure that you are putting those into the chat. I'm just checking because there's quite a few here. So first question is, what are your plans? I'll ask this to you, Thomas. What are your plans from a hardware perspective for 2021?
That's actually a good question. So in this short presentation, as you have seen, it was quite, of course, short because we had only like 20, 25 minutes. So we really focused on what was, you know, like new in terms, you know, like of the platform, which is really key here with the TIOS 3.0. We will share, of course, much more like information, much more dedicated webinars in the coming weeks with actual demonstration of the platform. Now, when it comes to hardware, we are launching and we just started to deliver our new and latest tablets, so 10-inch especially, with NFC built-in for the room booking and so on. So this is completely new. We are introducing also, as we speak, in the coming like weeks, our new sensors, so for the meeting room sensor, the desk sensors for the flex office, which will be available. So these were like the two priorities that we had for this quarter. And then we are looking for, of course, new possibilities linked to the development, of course, of TIOS, but that we will communicate on a later basis. Really, as a summary, it's really about the new tablets and the new sensors that we're providing now to the market.
Okay, great. A question here, when will 3.0 version be released? I think you mentioned that, but maybe just mention that again.
No problem. So as of now, it's still under QA audit. So we are doing all the quality tests and the debugging of the platform before to release it officially to make sure that what we provide to you is on the best, of course, possible level. So as of now, we are aiming middle of May and end of May the latest. So it will be within May. We'll communicate an official date very soon.
Okay. There's a question, is it possible to personalize the server address? So this person has rephrased it and says, my question is in the sense that the name, would it be possible to have like www.companyname.com without the TIOS in there to kind of like personalize that?
There might be like a redirection to do because this would be like on the hosting of the customer, I will assume. For us, we will provide, of course, with the TIOS address because it's really on the server side, but there will be like a redirection to do, I would assume, on the customer. Mm-hmm. But those are items that we can discuss, you know, like on specific projects. Again, for us, really the goal is to make sure that the way it is used by customer works for them. So we're really happy to discuss those specific needs, project by project, of course.
Okay. There was also the question from the same contact. Is there a way to select the country of hosting for the cloud solution?
Moving forward, maybe at the moment, no, we use like our European server from Amazon as a start. But moving forward, this is the type of things that we want to provide, yes.
Okay. Another question, how does the new business model impact existing customers and do they need to pay?
So it doesn't. So a customer, that's actually a good question also, which has already like purchased TIOS, so an actual customer with an actual system running in, will have to pay nothing at all to continue to use his system, of course. In terms of service, for the firmware updates, for the support, and so on, we'll make sure, of course, that what they use to purchase remain pretty much in place, at least for some time. So this will be part of the communication that we will do in May, June to those customers, giving them the possibility, of course, to renew their contract on the existing price. But there will be no change to their installation, of course. So nothing to buy in terms of server, nothing to buy in terms of software or new license. They continue to use what they have and to continue to work. If they have the service, they will be able to update, of course, with TIOS 3.0 without paying anything at all.
Okay, there's another one here. How can I get a demo of the cloud?
For now, at the moment, what would be the best is to contact your account manager or your pre-sales member from Sony, or to contact us, of course, directly after this webinar, and we'll make sure to enter in contact with you and provide you with the right information. Moving forward, we'll provide an online easy page for anyone to be able to access and require an access for the cloud. But this will come at the same time of the release, so somewhere within May.
Okay, thanks. I think that's all the questions. I'm trying to go through here. I'm hoping there's not just I'm missing some here. I'm going to have a look again. If I've missed any, I will get back to you. From what I can see, I think that's all the questions that we've had today. So thanks for your time today. You know, it was a great session. I really enjoyed it. I hope you did as well. Thomas, any final words before we end this seminar?
No, thank you. Thank you very much for attending. Thank you very much for your time with us. So like we said, this was really like a short introduction to TOS 3.0. On our side, we have, of course, some work to do still in order to make sure that what we deliver to you is at the best possible level, so between now and the middle of May, that we will continue to do. We will probably host one or two more webinars to go deeper in the platform to show you more the functionalities from a visual perspective and, of course, technical perspective. So this will be somewhere between middle of April to middle of May. Already middle of April. And of course, to make sure that you have all the information you need to use, support, sell, and of course, purchase TIOS. So thank you very much, everyone. Any question, please don't hesitate to contact us moving forward, and we'll be happy to take them, of course.
Thank you, guys, and enjoy Spark. Have a little explore, go into the platform, look around, and let us know what you think. Thank you, and have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.